sports. It's in the game.
We attacking, better stand back and watch a run shotgun. Same big blitz, nobody block you. Big win, that's a ring and a watch. Strong in when he come in the slot, trying to bend the corner of your limbs, getting that's your partner, then your twin game. All you want to do is talk, I don't need to talk.
Gotta hurry, somebody talk.
I can pull up with that, Chewbacca that. Banging my chest and my head on the line.
We are set, ready to rock for this Madden Ultimate Team matchup, and these guys on your screen, ready to rock as well. Some of the stars of today's game, and speaking of the game, let's get right to it. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. Patterson going to bring this out of the end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. Off play action, it's Cunningham. He'll buy some time right. Oh, he's going to take a shot right away. And incomplete on the deep ball.
Not the desired outcome, but probably won't be the last time we see him take a shot downfield.
Jerry Rice, the one he was looking for. And that'll bring up second down. A play fake. Now Cunningham sliding out of the pocket. Now on the run. He'll throw it back deep over the middle. And that's caught inside the 30. And he will score. Touchdown, Las Vegas. Jerry Rice, 81 yards. And the Raiders, on just two plays, have taken the lead. Well, if they didn't get the wake-up call before the game, they got it right now. Two plays already in the end zone.
I think of it in boxing terms, because whether it's a big shot with your first one or a probing one, a little bit of a jab, the second one was the payoff. That was the big one that landed. 1-2, end zone.
Following the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Carlson. A fairly short kick from the 14. And they're going to have good starting field position. He's out of bounds, but not before he's across the 35. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. The first carry for the Memphis man, Antonio Gibson. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11. Here's a throw to his running back. It's complete. And a five-yard gain gets him to the 42. We'll see what kind of mindset they have here offensively after giving up the touchdown on the opening drive.
And based on our time with them, you know, prior to this game, I feel like they've got a good mindset going in. In fact, the discussion that we had with the coaching staff was, you know, we may give up some points in this game, so our offense has to be ready each and every time.
And now the rookie screen.
I'm the best in the game.
And he's going to take it in for a Steeler touchdown.
It's a good one now. It's a good one.
Jamar Chase, 58 yards. And the Steelers are within a two-point conversion of tying this game. Extra point splits the uprights, and this is now a one-point game. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. Offense set to get this drive started. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
Jackson. And unable to get downhill there as he'll take this up to about the 37. Give him a couple on the carry there. Second and 8.
Oh, that's a real nice job there by the defensive front. They just engaged and held their ground. But how about the guy who made the play? We often talk about whether they take a good first step or not. Many times you just don't take any step. Just get your feet moving, get your body going. And then once he made the read, he was able to make the play.
Now, meanwhile, here's a second down throw that's knocked away and incomplete.
Quarterbacks work all the time on manipulating the defense with their eyes and their head movement. In this case, he just stared the receiver down. That allowed for excellent coverage, able to knock that one away.
So the failure to connect on second down, that leaves him staring up here at a 3rd and 8. Cunningham to throw. Dancing to his left. Now he'll square up and throw deep left sideline. And that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up 4th down.
He did a fine job there of not hitting him before the ball arrived. And I've got to tell you, you can often mistime that play because of the angles of approach. When you're going to get him, sometimes you panic as well and think, I've got to be there right now. Instead, in this case, timed it perfectly and knocked it free.
Now he's going to let it go deep back over the middle. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete. So certainly an interesting call there to go for it. And that will force a turnover on downs. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on 1st and 10. Gibson here running out of the gun. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. They'll run here with Gibson. He's able to work free for about 6 down to the 18. The last run got 6, now 2nd and 4.
Brings up 2nd and 4.
On play action, it's Mahomes. Open man right side is Ingram. And he's in. Touchdown, Steelers.
as bugle. Have you been tried in the fire? Have you been tried in the fire? Well, tell me, did you come through as bugle?
You kick it like the benefactor's benefactor. Well, truthfully, we know you never been a factor. Well, honestly, the truth is that you've been an actor. And now your actions got them boys about to mass up. Lectures from the devil got you piping hot. This up and you get screwed and chopped, no Michael Watts. When I was 10, I knew I should have been on rap a lot. Think like Jay Prince and I do more than just rap a lot. I went and got my digits up. Your favorite, bruh. You don't want no trouble, cuz the 25th, I got a meeting with the governor. That's real rap a lot, no cap a lot. I used to from Farron down to Camelot. I used to whip up in my granny's pot. She asked my friends, was I? They said, nope, he not. The mind to a praying woman. The truth's a heavy burden and it's weighing on me. Red Dog has caught me slipping with the willing on me. I went to calling out for Jesus like a reverend, homie. Chalked it up to sin, took it on my chin. Gotta take some L's if you wanna win. They took a, but then take a sin. I didn't even have no re-up I could re-up with. Had to rob another just to re-up. Pray to God it in his heart he find forgiveness for me. It was nothing personal, it was just business for me. When I got on, I paid him back and told him it was ugly. I'd rather ask forgiveness like 100 times than be asking for permission in a beggar's line. Cause of who I been, check out how I tend to mine. I got a partner who don't eat no poke at dinner time. But let you act like you gon' ever hurt or injure mine. He have your woman, then that's my dinner time. I keep my eyes on glory, tell the devil get behind. Now bear in mind the devil made me offers I decline. We not aligned, not combined, I am not confined to any wicked system that these demons have designed. They frame a mind and have you salty as a bacon rind. I'm trying to mastermind how to help out humankind. I'm open mind, but I do not rock with none aligned. My state of mind is to keep a peace for peace of mind. I'm like Malcolm with my piece at the Venetian blinds. I'm trying to manifest some things in my subconscious mind that I have only seen in dreams in my unconscious mind. My dreams unrefined, swing the mind, a state of mind that make it seem this lucky life of mine is pre-designed. And if it is, then thank the Lord, cause that's the mastermind.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Kick a punt, then I make a catch. 5,000 ones in an hour, I'ma make it stretch. I just made a mess, I just made a mess. I got cash by the bundle, so I never press. I just made a mess, I just made a mess. 50-yard TD, we do winning catch. Oh no.
Clean it up. make it stretch. I just made a mess, I just made a mess. I got cash by the bundle, so I'll never press. I just made a mess, I just made a mess. 50-yard TD with the winning catch. Oh no, oh no, oh no, no, no. I just made a mess. Oh no, oh no, oh no, 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 no. I just made a mess.
Only religion was the moolah. Made a couple million, hallelujah. Daddy was a toy. Called a homeschooler. Never did homework, I was gone home with the work, no tutor. Used to have enough. Grew up with the hustlers and the killers. Now I'm kicking it with Puffy in the villa. Chillin', click full of zombies like Thriller. Got real, about to get real. That's just how I'm feeling. I'ma burn it all to the ground. Make sure the whole world feel it. That's just how I'm feeling.
Cameras in my face.
What do I do
to keep getting the love from my state?
What do I do
to keep the money coming in.
What do I do?
Writing until I need another pen.
Gotta make the right decision, or it might just be my last. People view everything different when you touching on the back. What you see as good intentions is for clout and hitters, man. You can never be a self to carry, gotta wear a mask. They be pulling at you, grabbing at you, pop up, trying to change you. I built my own foundation and there ain't no rearranging. Moving careful every day is exactly how I played it. Not looking for number one, but that's exactly how I'm placing. Feel like Jesse Owens, cause I'm taking off with the race. Put the metal to his mouth, retain his tongue, hold the brace. But I'm all about the peace until the sucker hit a make. Oh man, eat man, your performance kinda shaky. I'm prepared for the fame, I like that crap, so I'm really like me. But I'd be lying if I said I didn't cry at least once a week. Cause I'm so blessed with no stress, all the weight taken off of me. My head in the clouds and I smile like no grandma watching me. My dream came true, I'm loving all these cameras in my face. I never knew that I would get the love from my stay. Stay with the blue, always keep the money coming in. Ain't nothing new, writing until I need another pen. Gotta make the right decision, or it might just be my last. People view everything different when you touching on the back. What you see as good intentions is for clout and hitters, man. You can never be a self to carry, gotta wear a mask. They be pulling at you, grabbing at you, pop up, trying to change you. I built my own foundation and
CDs and pass them around. I used to email the venues and ask them if I could be opening act for the rappers that's passing through town. I used to be the one kids in my city was laughing about. I used to envision everything happening now. I used to ride the bus and listen to Kendrick Lamar. He just liked the video that I made back when I started to study his bars. I'd like to think that he probably related to someone that's come so far. To someone that wanted it badly, then when it got it and turned to a star. Overly dedicated, a title that resonated. I wanna be recognized, I wanna be decorated. Truthfully, back then I couldn't imagine a life where I never made it. Go ahead and let him hate it.
Let him hate it.
I ain't never had no money. I've been out here trying to get me away. Ain't nobody helping, I was hungry. Fake friends, they just slipping away. Now I got it, so I fall. Man, like every day. For all the time, nobody helped me, said I fall on you. Man, like every day. For all the time, you dated, man, I fall. Man, like every day. Until the day I pass away, I say I fall on you. Man, like every day. Man, like every day.
I'm ready for more.
If you fired up, I'm fired up.
Don't run from rap.
1, 2, 3.
Hey. I'm ready for more. Tell them I'm ready for more. Game time. I'm ready for war. Tell them I'm ready for war. Yeah.
I just got 20, I'm running on empty. There's more where that came from, my money is silly. I feel an envy, not trying to be friendly. It is what it is, if you want me, come get me. Whenever you ready, no, I keep it steady. Yeah, I get the W, throw the confetti. Please do not tempt me, don't hold it against me. We about that action, don't ever forget it. Squad of gorillas, the army, the navy. When I call a play, I'ma score like I'm Brady. The title is mine, if you want it, come take it. I'm ready for more. Tell them I'm ready for more. I'm ready for war. Tell them I'm ready for war.
I'm ready for more.
Oh, it's hard in the field, yeah, we
tell them I'm ready for more.
I'm ready for war.
Tell them I'm ready for war.
If you looking for me, you know where to find me. I leave you dusted, I leave you behind me. I flip the switch from 0 to 90. If you do too much, I'ma do the almighty. You know I got it, you know I'm a legend. You know I'm the one, I do not come in second. Please do not tempt me, don't hold it against me. We about that action, don't ever forget it. Squad of gorillas, the army, the navy. When I call a play, I'ma score like I'm Brady. The title is mine, if you want it, come take it.
I'm ready for more. Tell them I'm ready for more. I'm ready for war. Tell them I'm ready for war. I'm ready for more. Tell them I'm ready for more. I'm ready for war.
And now we get a peek at some of the top players here for this Madden Ultimate Team matchup. Brandon Gaudin, Charles Davis ready to go in the booth. We hope you're ready to go at the controls. Let's play. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. This fielded right at the goal line. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. To throw, Vic. steps away to his left. Big hold to the 30. Vic into the slide, and he's got the first.
Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there, not there. After about the third one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
A big hitter to start the drive has him up near midfield here for first and 10. Working out of the gun, Michael Vick. The first catch of the game for George Kittle. And they'll work this down to the 40-yard line, tackled there.
For a tight end, he's got good straight line speed. And on that route, he's often the guy that gets overlooked. Nice job there of finding him in stride for really good yardage.
And he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here, second down. The last run got a couple here, second and 8. It's a play fake. Now Vic being chased out left. Under pressure, and he will go down. Sacked back at the 38. Derrick Brown in there to drop him for a loss on the play. They'll need to get it to the 30 for a first. This is third down. Throwing, Vic. Here's Johnson with a reception. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20.
I think when they look at their offense, they think to themselves, weapons, weapons everywhere. And they want to move the ball around. They want to spread it to different people. But you absolutely know they want to get this man involved as well. And that's what they just did on that play.
Now a throw to the end zone on first down, but it winds up incomplete.
Nice play there to force the incompletion. And to me, one thing's for sure. When you're the underdogs and you're playing on the road, you absolutely have to get takeaways. You've got to get the ball from them.
Yeah, win that turnover battle, going to be key. They didn't get one there, but you get the feeling they keep making plays like that, they might just get a few.
Yeah, once you get one, defensive teams think they come in bunches.
Rolling to his left. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. It's just a gain of a couple there on the scramble, and now it's third down.
He was able to get away earlier in the drive, but apparently all the time they put in practice finally came to the front, didn't it? They remembered their lessons and found a way to contain him when he took off on that one.
Seventh play of the drive, forthcoming on third and 8. Here's Michael Vick. And he's got his man in stride, complete. Touchdown! Brandon Marshall, a 14-yard touchdown. And the Jets take the ball down the field and score on their opening drive. Matt Amendola now for the extra point. He's got it, and the Jets lead 7-0. Now to kick this one away, and off it goes. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully.
The Steelers take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
And this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30. Second and 5. Shotgun handoff to Gibson. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. A handoff for Gibson. And hard running's going to get him over the 40 to the 42. A good run, got 7 on first. Here's second and 3. Here's a give to Gibson. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. Call a no gain that time as it's going to leave him with a 3rd and about 3 to go. After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. The Jets will bring in a nickel set as they try to stop this third down. Mahomes now to throw. Got a man. It's Randy Moss complete. And he goes out of bounds. It looks like right at the 50. Third and four. He did just enough. I mean, just enough to move the chains.
And that's all you're looking for, right? Just want to keep the drive moving. You don't need the big play there. Just get to that marker that you described. And he was able to do just that.
5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down. After the pickup of five, here's second and five. Play action. Now it's Mahomes. He'll complete this to Ingram as tight end. And this winds up a gain of four to the 41. They'll run with Gibson. And he will have a first down here at about the 40. A carry for Gibson. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine. They go play fake. Mahomes finds his tight end, Ingram. That throw good for only a couple. It brings up third down. Now Mahomes. A bullet throw, but incomplete.
From the snap, he certainly looked like he knew where he wanted to go with the ball, but surprise, that guy was covered. So that took his attention elsewhere to no avail.
So it looks like the offense isn't going anywhere. They're going to go for it on fourth and seven. Throwing now is Mahomes. And the pass is intercepted. He was looking for Ingram. Picked off by Ty Law. And the Jets are going to have it here at their own 32-yard line. What a start defensively. Your offense goes out, gets the touchdown, and then you get the interception. Just perfect.
How about the discipline that they showed on defense? Because after the offense scored to go up 7-0, you would think they might be a little extra aggressive trying to get back at them. Instead, they read their keys well. When they took the shot downfield, they were more than prepared for that one.
And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard. He's going to sling this deep downfield. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by Fabian Moreau. And the Steelers are going to take possession here at their own 33. Well, look, we're watching a quarterback here that's obviously been around for a long time. That's a throw he wishes he had back.
He certainly does, but as you well know, this is a guy that's used to taking a few chances, used to fitting it into tight windows. These are throws that he's made before. Didn't happen to get it completed in this case.
Mahomes' throw here taken in by Ingram. 3 yards the gain there, second down. Here's Mahomes. That's out to the flat for Gibson. And a 5-yard gain gets him to the 42. Now the Steelers use the first of their three timeouts as the clock stops here with 46 seconds remaining in the first half. The Jets will bring in a nickel set here as they try to stop this third down. Looking to throw is Mahomes. Got a man. It's Chase. He completes it. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. The Steelers signal for the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 40 seconds remaining in this first half. And he'll complete this to Gibson. Call it a gain of 6 on the play, and that'll bring up second down. To throw, it's Mahomes. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by the Pro Bowl safety, Cam Chancellor. Second straight drive now here, Charles, that have ended with an interception.
And I just wonder, because I don't think it's going to rattle him necessarily, but I also wonder if it's going to nerve him a little bit. Does it lead to another one, or does he find a way to pull it together and become sharp again?
And now this is intercepted. My goodness. Picked off at the 48. And he brings this one back. It's a pick six for a Steeler touchdown. Short throw pick six right there. Those linebackers, they love when those short throws come and those eyes get real wide, don't they?
How about the anticipation on the play? Reading, reacting, and then the ability to catch the football and take it in the opposite direction.
Extra point right down the middle, and we are tied here in the second quarter. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The New York offense taking over for their next possession. And with 5 seconds to go, this will likely be our final play. This will be the final play of the half. Vic eluding the pressure right. And this is going to be caught, but they'll say out of bounds. So it's incomplete. Time for a break. We've hit halftime. 2 quarters down. 2 still remain. We step aside. This is the NFL on EA Sports. And we welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, set and ready to rock for the third quarter. Set and ready to go for the second half. 1 touchdown apiece, 7-7 our score. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. To this point, the results have not been good. 2 possessions, 2 turnovers.
And that's obviously something that can't continue, but to go a little bit deeper on that one, I would think about some play calls now, not even necessarily to my best player, but to someone I can trust with the ball, try and get things settled down a little bit.
Three yards on that last carry. Here's 2nd and 7. Mahomes going to throw. He'll check that down to Gibson out of the backfield. And give him 6 yards here as he stopped near the 35 at the 34.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
Mahomes to throw on 3rd and 1. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and it'll fall incomplete.
Oh, that's got to frustrate him a little bit because they nearly got to him there, and it would have been the first sack of the game instead. They're able to influence the release, and they did force the incomplete pass.
And how about this one now? In their own territory, a gutsy call. They're going to go for this on 4th and 1. They'll go for it. It's Mahomes. That ball caught by the former Toledo Rocket, Deontay Johnson.
And that's a big pickup of a first down. And you know that all week, both sides of the ball, offense and defense, are going through every situation. And in this case, the offensive guys had the right play dialed up because defensively, you work on 4th down situations as well.
And deflating for the defense. They can't get the stop here. On 1st and 10, it's Gibson. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50.
We don't talk about it very often, but sometimes there's a dip in intensity when you start the second half, which can manifest itself in some sloppy tackling. And how about right there? He ran right through that weak tackle attempt.
They'll run. It's Gibson. And he's corralled, but not before getting it inside the 35. 51 yards rushing for him now on what was his 10th carry of the ball game. Consecutive plays now where that offensive line has really created a lot of space.
And we've seen the confidence rise, haven't we? It borders on arrogance now, and that's that good arrogance, believing you can run the football whenever you get good and ready.
They'll run on first down. Gibson, and he's going to get 7 out of this before being taken down at the 27.
Hey, when you get good yardage like that on first down, it really does a whole lot of good for your entire offense. But I love the way he's finishing those runs. At the end of things, he's making sure he gets just a little bit extra.
Second down, a run with Gibson. And they'll work it inside the 15-yard line before it's all said and done.
I hope we give enough respect to the big guys up front because they have been getting it done on this drive. The holes have been large, and they've been barreling through them, picking up first downs.
Here's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line. Now Gibson, and he'll fight his way down right around the 12. 2 yards on the carry there, it'll be second down.
Oftentimes we praise an offense for their variety and being able to hit people with the run in the pass, but in this game, how about what we're seeing from the safeties? They are all over the field, doesn't matter if they threw it or if they're trying to run it.
I don't think we've ever awarded an MVU most valuable unit, but you're right, it might go to them in this game.
I like that, MVU, well done.
On second down now, it's Gibson, and he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line. It'll be first and goal when we come back. You are watching Madden Ultimate Team on EA Sports. A field goal could get him the lead, but it might not be enough here as they come up on first and goal. Gibson, and he's going to get this back to the 3-yard line and no further. No gain on the play that time, and it sets up second and goal. His carries tonight, they're getting up there, so maybe one of those every now and then is understandable.
I would agree with that. Understandable every now and then. Sometimes you come back and you fake it to him and go play action, but other times you say, okay, they got him on that one. We'll come back to him in another carry.
And they'll bring him down after just a short pickup. They get 3 yards closer, but still work to do. It's third and goal. They'll try to run with Gibson. And he's going to take it in for a Steeler touchdown. Antonio Gibson. Fine work there on the touchdown run. And the Steelers have taken the lead. Point after, right down the middle. And that makes the score 14-7. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. They'll elect to bring it out here from the end zone. And he's probably realizing he should have stayed in the end zone as he can only muster a return to the 14-yard line. The New York offense taking over for their next possession. And now, after the touchdown a moment ago, they work from behind in a 7-point game in this fourth quarter. Plenty of time on the clock. Here's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line. Vic to throw it. Flush to his right. Vic into the slide, and he's got the first.
How many times have we seen this late in the fourth quarter? Because you know the pass rush is getting after him, and they get upfield, get that great push, And what do they create? Space, and he takes off.
First down, Vic. Forced out to his left. And he's going to be down at the 35. Gain of 7.
They brought the blitz that time, and I thought they were going to get to him, but instead, he flipped it on its ear and ended up picking up positive yardage.
I thought he was dead to rights, but you are exactly correct, sir. Able to turn that into a positive gain. Here's a throw to his running back. It's complete, and he goes out right around the 39. Working the sideline there. Good route, good catch. First down, and he gets out of bounds.
They have to like the play calling because you have to run some guys down the middle of the field to draw some of the defenders away. They can't just let them guard the sideline exclusively. That's how it's going to work. Sidelines and incompletions to use the clock.
5 yards on the catch there. Brings up second down. Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game. So it's Jets football as we get you reset here. They come up on a second down now in a game that looks like it's going to go down to the wire. Buying time to his left. Vic into the slide, and he's got the first.
Looks to me, partner, like he's learned a little bit because earlier in the game, I think he was trying to force a lot of throws into some windows that just weren't open.
Yeah, the interceptions had plagued him, especially a second interception, really a bad throw. So maybe a better decision there.
Yeah, no doubt about it. I think he learned from earlier in the game, and he's applying it now.
Vic with the incompletion on first down, and now that leads to second and 10. Vic flushed out right. And right back to Kittle. This time he's got it. Here's the 7th play of this drive. This is 3rd and 4. Here's Vic. Oh, hit as he throws there, incomplete. Charles, I think back to your earlier statement about the visitors being the underdogs needing to win that turnover battle, and this defense, they forced 2 turnovers so far, a big reason why they lead this game.
Yeah, and I know defenses always talk about getting turnovers in bunches, getting those takeaways. 2's not a bunch, but it's plenty in this game, exactly the formula they need. And I got to tell you, partner, I like it when you think back to something I said that actually comes true, that's actually right.
It happens more often than you might think. They had to go for it with such little time remaining, and that's going to be just about all she wrote for this one. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. And this game, not quite in hand yet. We'll likely see all 3 timeouts defensively and then reassess where we are. And he'll work it across midfield inside the 45. The Jets are going to use the first of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds left to go in the game. On first down, right back to Gibson. And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down. Have to imagine this will be on the ground as well as they come up 2nd and 7. Here's Gibson.
I like that run right there, partner. Not the flashiest run, not the one that's going to break for big yardage, but he understands the situation and taking care of the football, paramount. He got it done.
Nursing that slim lead, you're exactly right. Hold on to that ball. On third down, here's Gibson. And he is going to have the first down, and that is going to suck the life right out of this crowd.
I like a guy who understands the situation. I also like a guy who you look at him and you say, that looks like a guy who knows the coach is going to say, guess what? You drop this one, you'll be carrying around the training facility for an entire week.
Maybe flashback to high school or college, carrying it around campus, right?
Maybe the old gauntlet drill, right? Anyone get the ball out while he's sitting in class and bring it back to the coach? He's in big trouble.
So this one in the win column for the Pittsburgh Steelers. And, you know, it wasn't a shutout. They did give up the points in the first quarter, but 2nd, 3rd, and 4th quarter, they held them scoreless.
Brandon, if you throw a shutout for quarters 2, 3, and 4, you're going to win a lot of games in this league. And this felt a lot like, almost like if you say baseball, and the pitcher goes through the lineup the first time and the hitters get to see him, and then they come out after that and the bats start blazing, right? I think they saw their best stuff in the first quarter and just shut everything down from that point on. What a great, convincing performance.